Okay, folks, Darcy Oak, son of Scott. He lost over in England, but he did great. We got a little thing going here. Let's face it, folks. It was the first time it wasn't judges. It was call-in, if you can believe it, in England. How do you ever think he's going to win with a call-in? He did a great job, but it was a call-in, you know, so the votes in that, they don't even know about Canada. They didn't even mention we were in the D-Day, so how are they going to mention Darcy? Congratulations, did a great job anyhow. Great, eh?
Brilliant.
Boy, he should have won.
Darcy Oak, you want a magician, you want a show. You got it right there. So the giveaway, speaking of magic acts.
Again, the guy in the corner, Williams is in the corner, and you're going to have to watch this. There he is. He just should be up at the right point. Watch, he gives it away to the guy, and here's a shot from the point. And the funny thing is, after he gives the puck away and the guy scores, he goes out to the point. Watch. He throws it away, throwing the puck. He should be out at the point. Shot goes in off the guy, and he's going. Look, he's out at the point. I mean, absolutely ridiculous. And I'm not going to hurt Girardi again, but it was the same thing for New York last night. Well, go ahead. We're short. He throws the puck away. Nobody at the point. Watch it goes in. I feel sorry for him, but watch the shots from the point. Are you people starting to believe me about shots from the point? Don't give the puck away. Stand up at the point, and here it is again. The right winger is outside.
You think maybe, Don, they had such a bad third period, the Rangers, the other night, that they tried to get aggressive, and that's
no, the LA's got them right where they want them, down 2-0.
It's incredible. Here's one of the things, that's the 15th time out of 22 games New York's got the first goal.
Now, let me tell you about the 2-0. And you're up 2-0. I long, about 20 years ago, I said this. Nobody believed me. You got 2-0. You don't know whether to be aggressive or you don't know whether to lay back. And you're really in between. But they're at home. They got to go.
Unspoken acts here. 2D guys.
You know, Scott did a great interview with Muzzin and Doughty, and they said, we want to play together forever. And watch. I'll show you why. Watch. Here's Doughty. Backhand. Like that. Talk about a giveaway if the guy. Anyhow, that's why. Watch this here. He knows he's there. He doesn't even look. And I always said, it's more important to have defense play together than forwards anytime. Daryl Sly, we played together for 6 years. He carried me for 6 years.
And Grapes, you had Bobby Orr, who was raw emotion at every turn. And here's Drew Doughty. He's a wired guy. But before we get to Drew and the other night, Taves, yeah, same thing.
Here's the thing. The best player has always got a lot of passion. You remember Seabrook going over. Taves, without a doubt, is the best player in Chicago. He settles him down, the veteran. The other night there, Doughty, he is their best player on either side. And there, hey, look, there's Green and Carter. Settle down. He's yelling at him. And I really love the next one was Voinov. He grabs him. Like, this is kind of touching. Settle down, the best player you got. But they play with such passion. That's what happens.
Kind of touching.
All right.
Remember what I used to say with a referee? When I go in, you know, a lot of times I yell relax. I never yell relax ever to players in a big game. I'd always say, hey, take it easy for your team needs you.
Yeah,
and that was one that would work. Little one-on-ones at the practice yesterday, Don, watching Daryl Sutter work.
No, wait a minute. When I used to coach the Bruins, I never bring a guy in the office if I was going to talk to him. I tell you why. And you people remember when they bring him in the principal's office and you're always upset. But you always say, no, look, watch. He's just talking to the guys. He's going around talking to the guys. Should have talked to a few guys down 2-0. But that's the way to do it. Go, you young coaches out there, don't bring them in your office or anything like that. Talk to them on the ice like that. They feel a lot better.
Just seeing that, you said something neat about Martin Jones. I thought, why would he be talking to the backup goaltender, Martin Jones, Daryl Sutter?
Well, I said to you, those guys sit a lot and they see a lot and they come up with things that nobody else sees because they're into the game, or they should be.
Henrik Lundqvist, you pointed out using the Dan Bouchard stick, or that's our theory on it, the flat blade.
Yeah, well,
shaft.
I call it Dan Bouchard. He puts a little tape on there because it was a little too on his. But watch the save he makes right here with it. You guys should think about that. You could just cut that off like that. Now you see it like that. It comes across. I think if you see it again, he goes, there it is. Look at this. He goes like that, down. He doesn't have that stick. It's in the net. Well, we have to talk about something that happened in Moncton, and we'll put up the first guy, and we'll talk about it. But first of all, I'd like to say that in the line of duty, we risk a speedy recovery to Eric Dubois and Darlene Gauguin. Darlene was shot in the neck, and we speedy recovery. Condolences to the family. Constable Doug Larch from St. John's, New Brunswick. But you know, Ron, his dad is retired. He was a Mountie too, like that. He was in the highway patrol. You know, he just received a commendation from saving a baby's life. And he has a wife and three lovely daughters. Doug was 40 years old. And then we have Constable Fabrice Javadan. He just returned. He was out and he had a head injury in the line of duty. He just got back from an injury. He got a lovely wife and a young daughter, 45 years old. And, you know, these guys were killed in the line of duty by a monster. And we have Constable David Roth from Victoria, Quebec. He has a wife and young son and another one on the way. And he was with the K-9 group, great guys. And you know, Ron, he was 32 years old. And these guys, every night, every day, they go out and they give their life on the line. They are the greatest guy. Imagine getting up in the morning and you go and he never comes back again. The last words he said to his mom was, "Mom, remember, I love you."
Coach's Corner on CBC, brought to you by Budweiser Red Lights, making playoff goals brighter.